Earlier this week, the Surgeon General of the United States, Dr. Jerome Adams, was in Hawaii to assure the state government and the city county of Honolulu that help is on the way as the Aloha State continues to receive new cases in triple digits. He also points out that certain ethnic groups are among the hardest hit by the coronavirus. For more, here's Ron Hamilton.
Earlier today at the Honolulu Fire Department headquarters, Mayor Kirk Caldwell announced that a second stay-at-home, work-from-home emergency order has been approved by Governor David Ige and will take effect on Thursday, August 27th. During a press briefing, Mayor Caldwell pointed out the main objectives of the latest order.
One, we're going to be doing surge testing for the next 2 weeks. 5,000 tests a day. That's 70,000 tests in 14 days. No city has actually hit the 5,000 level, but we're working hard to do so. Number two, more contact tracing. The city wants to join that effort and wants to hire somewhere between 250 and 500 contact tracers to work in coordination with the Department of Health and General Hara to do a more aggressive approach to contact tracing.
In addition, the mayor and U.S. Surgeon General Jerome Adams emphasized that a couple ethnic groups had been disproportionately affected by the coronavirus.
When we find those positives, they cannot be quarantined with other members of their family who continue to go to work and spread the virus, particularly in our Pacific Islander community and in our Filipino-American community, where we see an increasing number of cases.
And you heard the mayor mention that the Filipino community has been particularly hard hit. I got data this morning over at Kapi'olani Hospital that helped illustrate the fact that the Filipino community has been hard hit in terms of numbers of people dying and percentages of people dying from this virus. We know that people from the Pacific Islands represent about 4% of the population here in Hawaii, but about 30% of the cases. That is astounding. That is astounding to me, and it's why we want to make sure our surge testing is allowing us to get some visibility into those communities.
Honolulu City Council Member Joy Manahan, himself a Filipino-American, representing one of Hawaii's largest Filipino communities, had some frustration that Honolulu should have been allowed to invest in more preventative measures back in the spring when new cases were still in the single digits.
Early on, we tried to get testing into the community health centers, but you know, the state government's decision not to test and trace while the curve is flat is now stressing our health systems and the economy. The DOH tied the city's hands when we offered to test communities on the front line of the pandemic back in April. Testing on Oahu has not been equitable. The state's decision to coordinate testing with hospitals only is proving costly for our working families who access their health care at a federally qualified community health center. I'm glad that the federal government and the county are stepping in to provide more social justice and equity in the current testing and tracing programs. This is welcome news, not just for me in my district, but really for the county of Oahu and for the state of Hawaii. So I'm really looking forward to this new effort. I hope we can get a handle on it while the curve is flat, and I'm confident with everybody here helping, we can.
To recall, back in early May, Eagle News reported on a study by the University of Hawaii School of Medicine stating that the highest rate of COVID-19 cases in several U.S. states, including Hawaii, are among Native Hawaiians and Pacific Islanders, more than any other racial and ethnic groups. From Honolulu, Hawaii, this is Ron Hamilton for Eagle News. We live in interesting times.
Thank you, Ron.